is this book worth your money? We'll find out. You probably recognize him in the role as play-by-play announcer.
Yeah, but Steve Physioc is also an award-winning author. So good morning and congratulations on your book, The Walls of Lucca. You won the Reader's View Award for Best Historical Fiction. So for those who have not read that book, what's it about?
The Walls of Lucca is about two families trying to produce a great Sangiovese wine in Italy's dark times of World War I, the rise of fascism, and Mussolini. And Above the Walls take place in, picks up the, it's the sequel, in 1938, after Mussolini writes his Manifesto of Race, which aligns himself with Adolf Hitler, and how it affects the vineyard operators, the agriculture workers, and all of Italy.
Why in the world would you write about this subject?
You know, in 2006, my wife and I were touring in Italy, and I had this vivid dream in southern Tuscany of a great walled city, families struggling to produce a great wine, and then we go off on our adventure to Venice and to Florence, and a week later we're joining friends in Lucca, Italy, and as we're driving in, I go, Stacy, this is it. This is the walled city that was in my dream.
No
was
way.
That so now like I'm a interested. God-inspired thing?
It may have been, but now I'm interested, so I bought a book about the history, and I just started writing. And I finished writing 11 years later, and these are the two books about that vision in my head.
Wow, that is so cool. So,
are you a big wine fan, too?
I am now.
Okay.
So did you? What lessons did you learn from baseball when it came to writing a book?
Well, I think I've always been interested in team sports. Mm-hmm. And there's always going to be challenges in life. And what the Royals are going through right now, they're 2-9. But I do believe...
A wall.
Well, yes, there's a wall there. But we don't experience 14 and 15 if we don't have 2011, 12, and 13.
Oh, yeah.
I believe in what the Glass family is
doing
and Dayton Moore is doing. And that's the same thing true here. Whether you're working at a vineyard or a baseball organization, they're going to go through troubles. They've got a great wine. But World War I is happening. Mussolini's happening. Things are getting in their way. But if they keep track of their goal to produce a great wine, they probably will. And the same thing is true with our Royals. 2-9, but if they keep their sight on the goal, they're going to realize success.
And that means proper fertilization.
Yep.
Proper watering.
Mm-hmm.
And proper pruning.
Right. And allowing the roots to go through the difficult parts of the ground. Mm-hmm. The roots have to go through slate and dirt and struggle to produce that grape you're talking about.
It's kind of cool to see what Whit Merrifield is doing, though.
He's the classic example of keeping your eye on the ball. I mean, last night, to get that hit, to extend his hit streak, on a bunt, because he recognized the situation. He wasn't thinking about himself. He saw the third baseman back, tying run at third, do your job, he does it, and he's the very epitome of what a great baseball player is, a thinking ball player.
Well, thank you so much for joining us. I think it is so fascinating that not only do you have this great talent that we all know of with the Royals, you've got another one as well. The Walls of Lucca and Above the Walls are both available on Amazon right now. Historical fiction. I love historical fiction.
Yes.
So
this is one wall that everyone can agree on, right?
Yes. And I want to do a little shout out to my marketing person here in Kansas City, Carrie Holtzman, who has done a great job. And it was her idea to do a certain marketing strategy where we had 40,000 downloads in a 3-day period in February, and we had 50,000 total downloads from the U.S., Canada,
to
England,
download the
France.
Whole book?
Yes.
Wow.
Most
cow.
Of it's e-books now. So, Carrie, thank you very much.
I need to get her number.
Thanks,
I'm working on a little bit.
There you go.
All right.